Our next speaker has always been an artist seeking golden rules with her career at hand. She has been class historian for the last 3 years and was actively engaged in designing class sweatshirt. And today she's going to share some wisdom of golden rules in relationships. Please help me welcome Rachel Perez Mamani.
Here, all of you.
Thank you.
Yeah, don't worry about them. You got it? Okay. The golden rule. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Now, we've probably heard this our whole lives, even when we were a little kid, but the question is, do we really act on it? This saying goes far beyond simply being kind to people or going out of your way to be available or helpful to those in need. Yes, you would want others to assist you in a bind or to be pleasant even in an unfavorable circumstance, but there are many ways to create equality in our world that may go completely unnoticed. Guys, it's really just about adjusting our views and attitudes. Instead of just treating others the way you want to be treated, think about others the way you want to be thought of. Feel about others the way you want others to feel about you. Speak to others the way you want to be spoken of. Realistically, the human heart is inherently selfish. Even our most seemingly unselfish acts come from a desire to feel good about ourselves and look good before others. While people may appear to be unselfish, the deepest motive of the human heart is to not help others, but help our own image and even our self-esteem. On a religious aspect, God sees our heart and knows its true motives. So when Jesus tells people to treat others as they would like to be treated, he's speaking directly to the deepest feelings of the heart and confronting its wickedness. An assumption can be made that morals derive from the golden rule. If everyone could take the golden rule into consideration, it would better the society as a whole. People need to put themselves in the shoes of others to gain more knowledge of what it's like on the opposing side. Once the person can see firsthand what it's like on the other side, then they'll realize their mistakes and look at things differently. For example, if a mother and daughter switch roles for one day, then they would actually be conscious of each other's responsibilities. For example, the daughter would gain more knowledge that the mother puts most of her needs before hers, and she does most of the work. And so the daughter would realize that, what the mother has to take on every single day. And after seeing this, she would now have more respect for her and try to help her. The mother would realize the pressure that the daughter has to deal with at school and so on, and would try to help her with her daughter rather than add more burden on her life. Even though it is not possible for everyone to switch roles for a day, it is important that we can visualize what it would be like to do so. People need to be more considerate. We are told that it is right to be moral by assessing the golden rule, so it would give people more morals. Morality is important for society as a whole, as it makes life more livable. Even the Messiah sat down and ate dinner with the sinners, and if only in our mind, we can do the same. Whether others treat you with kindness and compassion has no bearing on how you treat them. Become the compassion and respect you want to receive. It's easy for someone to be nasty to you if you're nasty to them, right? Don't give them that chance. Make it hard for people not to see you in the radiant light that you portray. Make them work to hate you, disrespect you, or be ugly towards you. Make it easy for them to love you and respect you and see you as the magnificent being you are.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
All right,
thank you.
Okay.